required if you get that handshake, everything else.
Why reset?
Why reset, yes. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters, and welcome guests. So, it all started in September 2008. My husband and I were in Seoul, Korea, for a design project we were doing for LG. The interesting thing is that I really didn't want to go to Seoul at the time. Because flying for 28 hours for the round trip, just for 1 hour, seemed like such a waste of time. But there was one of the requirements on the contract. But who would have thought that trip will become a reason for my next career? I was absolutely amazed the things I saw in Korea, how much it has changed. So I returned home, and I was thinking a lot about my home country. I was just so impressed with all the achievement they've made. They created an economic miracle, the 11th largest economy in the world. Samsung is the largest technology company in the world. South Korea is known as most wired country on earth. 40% of the top 100 female golfers are South Korean. And they are also known for many innovative cosmetics. And 90% of people go to university, which is the highest rate in the OECD countries. And South Korea is a tiny country. It's the size of the state of Indiana. But 70% of the land is uninhabitable. Then I start wonder, when there's such an incredible external transformation as a country, how do people keep up internally? And then after doing some research, I learned that South Korea is also number one in many areas. Highest suicide rate, the highest plastic surgery rate, and boy, we drink. We drink more than the Brits, Americans, and Russians combined. So I was wondering, why are they having these problems? So I did some more research, and then I learned I wanted to know about what are the root causes for these problems. Oh, one thing I forgot, another thing. Biggest gender wage gap. So I wanted to know more about these problems, so I did some more research, and I learned that some of the reasons for these problems are the high academic pressures on teenagers, not just high pressures, so severe pressure, and the roles of mothers and fathers in the family. And then one example is, there were words called goose families or goose fathers. And what they mean is, many parents there, they send their kids to overseas to study. And that's quite common here. You know many college students studying overseas. But the big difference is, they send their kids over there at very young age, like 10, 11, 12 years old. And one of the reasons they do that is so their children can speak English without having any accent. And then the fathers, normally they are left behind, and because quite often mothers accompany their children going overseas and living with their children. So fathers are left behind making money so they can send, you know, support his family overseas. And if the father is financially capable and he can go visit his family 2-3 times a year, those fathers are called eager dads. But the other fathers who are not as capable financially and he can only go see them like once a year, those nets are called a penguin net. So, and then also the obsession with materialism, which can often lead to a culture of competition and comparison. And then they also live in a conformist society, which means everybody thinks alike. Many of these issues are universal topics, but it seems like we Koreans just take it to the next level. And several people I spoke with, they describe Koreans being extreme. So I was very happy and I was very sad to find out what's going on in South Korea. So I decided to write a book, and it's called Reset, Moving Korean Culture Forward. So you may say, why are you qualified to write this book? You're not a social scientist or a psychologist. And South Koreans living in South Korea may say, well, you don't even live here. What do you know? So my answer to that will be, when you live in the wood, you can see the forest. It's almost impossible to have any kind of perspective from within. I wrote this book based on my personal experience and others in Korea and in the States. And I came here as a young adult with a solid Korean values. And as you can imagine, living here for over 36 years, some of those values have been evolved. And also I wrote this book as an insider and outsider. My goal is to share what I've learned in my life so far and still learning, having lived in both Eastern and Western cultures. But also I was very excited and motivated by the possibilities. Having seen what they've accomplished in such a short time period, I believe that they can do a lot more. But this time, it's not the external things like growing a bigger economy, but it's about shifting mindset, being happy, being your own person, but most of all, broadening the meaning of life. Thank you.